to the divine ordinances of God.
Thank you, Lord.
And so many of them walked away from Jesus. And what happened is that after all of them walked away, there were still those original 12 standing there.
Amen.
And so Jesus looked at them and said, what, brother?
Will ye also go away?
Will ye also go away? In other words, are y'all ready to leave too? And Peter go answer him. And what did he say?
Lord.
Lord.
To whom shall we go?
To whom shall we go?
Amen.
Thou hast the words of eternal life.
Thou hast the words
right.
of eternal life.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. But not only did he have the words of eternal life, he was eternal life.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
The name of the Lord.
We believe.
Amen.
And he said, we believe.
And are sure.
And are sure.
That thou art the Christ.
That thou art the Christ.
The Son of the living God.
The Son
Thank you, Lord.
Of the living God.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
And see, when you got confidence in this thing, can nothing sway you?
No.
Amen.
Nothing can move you. Y'all quiet.
Amen.
Nothing can turn you away from Jesus.
No, sir.
Amen. So Paul, when he encountered Jesus, he did not get caught up any longer in the knowledge that he had, but he was coming to show the people something.
Amen.
The Bible said he demonstrated the Spirit.
Amen.
There's a lot of people talking. There's a lot of people saying they are of God. But after the words are done,
yeah.
there is no demonstration.
Amen.
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 There is no demonstration of the Spirit and of power.
Amen.
Talk back to
Amen.
Me.
Amen. Amen.
There is no demonstration of the Spirit nor of power. Everybody can talk the good talk.
It's true.
But when it's time for action, nobody shows up.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And we in the church have to get to a place where we're not comfortable with just another fair speech.
Amen.
Talk back to
Amen. Me.
Amen.
We have to get to the place where we just don't want another good sermon.
Amen.
We don't want just another feel-good message.
Amen.
We want something that we can see.
Amen.
That's right.
Well, maybe I'm the only one that can
That's see right.
myself. I want something I can see.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't tell me about a God that can raise the dead, but I never see the dead raised.
Jesus. Jesus. That's right.
Don't tell me about a God that can heal somebody's body, but then nobody's being healed.
That's right. Yeah.
But I'm not satisfied
no,
when
sir.
I come to the house of God knowing people's bodies are plagued with diseases.
That's right.
And then they leave out of the house of God in the same predicament they came walking in here.
Amen.
I'm not satisfied.
Oh, Jesus.
And Paul said, my words meant nothing, but I came to show you something.
Amen.
The demonstration of the Spirit.
Hallelujah.
But I'm a believer that the Spirit still demonstrates.
Yes. Yes.
I believe that God still has power.
Yes, he does.
And I believe that God is still moving in the midst of his church today.
Yes, he is.
I'm not a type of individual that looks on the pages of the book and say that was for them.
That's right.
Oh, that happened to them. And that was in their time. Jesus.
Yeah,
but the Bible told us, he said, I'm going away to my Father. And when I leave here, the works that I do, you're going to do. And
pray
to her.
Amen.
Y'all quiet.
Amen.
greater works than these shall you do?
That's right.
Amen.
Jesus said, not only what I'm doing. See, some of us have got limited, my cool.
Come on now.
Because I'm going to run that devil out of here.
That's right.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
See, sometimes the enemy tries to come in the house of God. And
yes.
Intimidate the people of God. And I don't care how tired you is, I was here for the night of surrender to you.
That's right. That's right. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, Pastor.
And sometimes what happens is we get comfortable hearing about what happened, reading about what happened. And we done got to the place where now we don't take the word of God literally. We take the word of God figuratively.
That's the truth.
When he said, greater works than these shall ye do. Well, he didn't mean that literally. Brother Hayes, he meant it figuratively. When he said these things that I'm doing, you going to do, he didn't mean it literally. He meant it figuratively.
Okay.
In other words, when he said you're going to open blinded eyes, that means when the word of God comes to them. But to the Lord, you're going to open up their understanding. You know how we're trying to get sophisticated now?
Yeah.
And we're trying to make an excuse for why we lack the ability to do what Jesus did.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
When Jesus said, you're going to do what I'm doing, he meant you're going to do what I'm doing.
He meant just that.
Amen.
Amen.
And greater works than these shall you do, because I'm going back to the Father.
Thank you, Lord.
And so what happens is, we find the apostles doing what Jesus did.
Amen.
Don't tell me they didn't do it.
That's right. Yes, they did.
They did what Jesus did.
Yes, they did.
And we use the excuse that they could do it because he was with them.
Hey, that's what they said.
Praise the name of the Lord.
That's what they said.
Because he was with them. He walked with them and he talked with them and he was there with them. But you told me that God is in you. Y'all got to say that. I thought you told me that God was in you. He's not walking with you and he's not standing beside you. But brother, he's on the inside of you.
So what's
that's
wrong?
A deeper relationship.
That's right.
When you go from walking with somebody and when they step on the inside.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
If they did it while he was walking with them, what can you do when he's inside of you?
That's right.
See, that's why the enemy is not letting folks be filled with the Holy Ghost in a lot of these churches, because you know when you get God on the inside, then the power of God got to radiate out of you.
That's
and therefore he's fighting people being filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yes. It's the truth.
Because he knows if you get this Holy Ghost on the inside of you, you'll be able to look at demons and say, Minister Blair, you know, I don't believe in all of that. We ain't got to do all of that. But can I submit to you something? We got to do all this
and more. That's right.
Yeah, the book said add down to it.
That's right.
Amen. We can't take nothing away. If they did it then, we got to do it now.
That's right.
And I saw pointing on this scripture, because last night after a wonderful fellowship, we got around the table just talking about the goodness of the Lord. And,
thank you, Lord.
And I began to ponder just about the demonstration of the Spirit. We done came to church, and we done encountered good singing. We done came to church, and we done encountered good preaching. Yeah. We done came to church and we encountered nice buildings. Yeah. You know, we done encountered marble floors and diamond decked out chandeliers. And we done looked at all the beautification of the edifices and we now equated that somehow with the anointing and the power of God. Yeah. Yeah. We hear wonderful choir singing, wonderful praise teams going, musicians getting up and doing their due, and we've equated it with the power of God. But yet at the same time, with all that, there's still no demonstration of the Spirit.
That's right. My Lord Jesus.
No demonstration. Boston said that I've been filled up with the Holy Ghost for years.
Amen. Come on.
With no demonstration of the Spirit. Can I tell you something? If the only thing you got to show forth of the Holy Ghost is speaking in another tongue and wearing a long dress and wearing modest apparel and wearing suit jackets, if this is the only thing that people can connect with us when it comes to God, we in the wrong church.
Right.
But when people heard about the church of Jesus Christ,
come on,
tell it.
They didn't first say, oh yeah, you know, them people that don't do this and don't do that. Them that don't do this and don't do that. You know. They didn't equate that with them.
No.
When they heard of the Church of Jesus Christ, the first thing that came to mind was power.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
When they heard the name Church of Jesus Christ, they heard power.
Yeah.
They heard them folk that are over there laying hands on the sick and they came to help.
Amen. Amen.
They heard power. Y'all want me to prove it to you? Because y'all acting like a sophisticated crowd today. So let me prove it to you from the Word of God. Acts the 8th chapter. I feel good in here.
Thank you, Lord.
Acts the 8th chapter. And I'm going to show y'all a brother. Let's get ready to demonstrate the power of God. Y'all ready? Acts the 8th chapter. And let's start at the 5th verse.
Acts chapter 8.
Matter of fact, let's start at the first verse to get a little history behind what's going on in this scenario.
Amen.
All right?
Acts chapter 8. Verse,
yes, sir.
Verse
Acts
1.
Chapter 8 and verse number 1.
And Saul.
And Saul.
Was consenting unto his death.
Now, y'all remember the Paul that just sat here and wrote the epistle in Corinthians?
Uh-huh.
This is who they're talking about.
Amen.
Saul was consenting to Stephen's death.
Yes, he did.
Before the road of Damascus, he was a persecutor of the church.
Yes. Right.
When they stoned Stephen, Paul was there.
That's right, holding the coat.
Holding the coat of them that stoned Stephen.
That's right.
And the word said, what, brother?
And Saul was consenting unto his death. And at that time. There was a great persecution. Against the church. Which was at Jerusalem.
And see, let me stop there. Let me stop there.
Oh, yeah.
Because we acting like the church ain't supposed to be persecuted.
Come on now.
Nowadays, everybody getting along. Everybody rubbing shoulders together. Everybody's unified. Everybody holding hands and singing kumbaya. Everybody coming to the same conventions and everybody doing the same thing. But can I tell you something? The Church of Jesus Christ is meant to be persecuted.
Amen.
Y'all ain't got to say nothing to me. Jesus said, if they hated me, they gonna hate you.
That's the truth.
And why folk talking about us and why folk looking at us like that and why folk don't want to come, because it comes with the territory.
Yes.
When you decide to name the name of Christ and walk this holy way, folk will persecute.
Yes. Amen.
The book said everybody that will live godly will suffer persecution.
Amen.
The book said if you don't suffer with him, you will not reign with him.
Amen.
Everybody want to reign, but don't nobody want to suffer.
Yeah.
woe be unto you when all men speak well of you.
That's
how I rejoice, Brother Jeffrey, when folks stop talking about
thank
me.
You
but I know I must be doing something.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Woe be unto you.
Jesus.
When all men speak well, I start getting nervous.
That's right.
Everybody patting me on the back. Oh, you a wonderful preacher. Can you preach at my church? And that's why that stuff don't move me.
That's
because
right.
One day they're asking you to preach, and the next day they're disfellowshipping you.
Yes.
Just one day they were saying,
yes.
Oh, say it out to you. But the next day they said, crucify him. Didn't you do so?
Yes, sir.
That's why I don't get moved with accolades. And that's why God packed me out of the opinions of people a long time ago. That's why folks can roll their eyes and look at me funny, and it rolls off my back.
Thank
you,
Lord.
Don't be afraid of their faces. He says, speak it anyway.
That's right.
Give me what to say. Utter it out your mouth and speak it.
You Jesus.
You know what I do? I'm speaking anyway.
That's right.
Whether they hear or whether they obey,
yes,
I preach it anyway. Now we're living in a day and age where we now say, can we all just get along? Can we all just get along? Now, sister, brothers, I'm starting to see more clearly as the day go by, we all just can't get along.
That's
and the reason why we all just can't get along
tell
is
it.
Because Jesus said it.
That's right.
And if Jesus said it, it ain't nothing I can do about it.
That's right.
Jesus said, did you not know I didn't come to bring peace on earth, but I came to bring a sword?
That's what he said.
Didn't he say
yes.
It? He said, I came to divide.
Divide.
I don't
that's
know what
right.
Y'all thinking. I didn't come to just bring everybody together. He said, but I came to bring some together.
Yes.
He said, but I came to divide.
Yes, he did.
Didn't he say? Yes.
That's right.
He said, there gonna be five in a house. Three gonna be against two.
Yeah.
And two gonna be against three.
Amen.
Yes, he did.
Amen.
Didn't he say
the word?
And he said it wasn't gonna happen. Not over money. Not over trouble in the marriage.
That's right.
It ain't gonna happen because one wanted to go to the bar and the other one wanted to go to the mall. That ain't why we divided.
That's right.
He said it's gonna be because of the name of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
He said for Jesus.
Amen.
When one wanted to go to the club, but the other one said, I'm going to the house
that's
of God.
Right.
And fight
until you
at all.
No, come on.
One going to the club, one going to the mall, it's peace. But the minute one say, I'm going to the house of God, next thing you know, conflict comes.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
One want to get their life right with God, and the other one still want to wallow in sin, there's a conflict coming.
Amen. Tell the truth.
That's why the book said no man can serve two masters. Either you got to love one and hate the other, or you got to hate the one and love the other. Man cannot serve God and mammon.
Amen.
And even let me teach a little bit on that. Because many times we heard we can't serve God and mammon. And we say God and the devil. But if you look up the word mammon means money.
Amen.
You can't serve God and money. You know how some of y'all trying to do. You trying to go make a quick buck, but you're neglecting God.
Come on.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Is it the power or is it God?
Amen. Tell the truth.
But it's a blessing. Who you serve? I serve God. My wife knows. There have been services that went to go on, and I wanted to be in the house of God, Brother Jeffrey, and I called my job and said, I ain't coming in here tonight.
Uh-huh.
What you take, what leave? I'll take sick leave if you got it.
Uh-huh.
And see, I had to lie, because they wouldn't ask you, are you sick? They just said, what leave you take? I'll take the sick leave.
Uh-huh.
I ain't talking about the sick. I'm just taking my sick leave.
Uh-huh.
Praise the name of the Lord. And I went to the house of God.
Amen.
But I realized that my soul was more important than just a dollar.
Yes.
And I seen God give back to us what we gave to him.
Yes.
I can tell y'all something. I can tell y'all something. The minister play ain't no liar.
Come on.
I done seen the handiwork of God. My wife said that we can attest to this. We went out to Atlanta to celebrate our anniversary. And we had a wonderful time in the Lord.
Thank you.
Oh, but the morning of Sunday.
My Lord.
It was time for us to get on that flight to come back home to make the service. The Lord knew it was in our heart to be here.
Yeah.
We got up there. We running. We done got through the security. And we done got through. And we like, we gonna make the plane. Get to the security booth. My wife is a nursing mother, so she had some milk. And on a little machine, if everything good, it comes straight down. But if something ain't right, it go off to the side. We see that little basket go off to the side. So we think when we get down there, everything gonna be fine. They gave us a hard time.
My Lord.
Over that milk, they rubbing about, they can clearly see what it is. And they gave us a hard time. So then they said, well, since this ain't going through, one of y'all got to get searched. I said, I'll get searched. Come on, you know, let's do this. We got to catch our flight.
Uh-huh.
So they come rubbing all on me and doing all this. He put his hand on the thing. Didn't want to tell me what was going on in money. I said, I had enough. Can I put my shoes back? No, I can't put your shoes back. I got to get on this flight, man. He come to me and tell me, he said, when I put my hand underneath there, it triggered the alarm. Something's on you. I don't know what it is. Something's on you. That's triggering the alarm. I'm over there looking at the clock. We got to go. Man, they waiting all this long time. Some man got to come down from head that's upstairs somewhere. Come down. And in a second, he come look at the stuff. He said, what's going on? He said, this man. He said, put her back in that door. Let them people go.
Right.
So you fuck. Let them people go. Something so minor we could have been gone. Now we running. And that airport is long. And we at terminal number one. And you would think that terminal number one would be when you first get there. We in the 20s. And we got to run all the way down the road.
Yeah. That's right. It's at the end.
Good God. We running, running. We hit on loudspeaker. Last call for the flight number. We running, running, running. We get there and the door shut.
My That's Lord.
Plane gone. I said, look at this.
My Lord.
So you know what we could have done? We could have just got a hotel and stayed until the next night. I said, no, I got to be in the house of God.
My Lord.
I got My to be Lord. With the saints of God.
Jesus.
I said, honey, get on there and look up another flight that's leaving within the next hour or so. We got to be back in New York. And or I can stay in the place that God put me and preach the gospel of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
I ain't staying on another night. We got to be. If I ain't there, who won't be there? I said, we got to go. Got on there, we started looking up flights, and my Lord Jesus. That thing said $400 for one ticket.
Yes.
I said, you got to be out your mind. We put it on in there. Found one that was three something. Got hers, got mine. Came up to $600-something. Close to $700. I said, now you know this. I said, you know what? I said, put it through.
Hello.
I knew what our bank account was looking like. I said, go on, put it through. I said, because we got to be in the house of God.
Amen. My Lord.
Go on, put it through. She put it through. And we came on. Got here late, but we got here.
Amen. 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 Amen.
And I could not afford, we could not afford to lose out on that money. Couldn't afford to lose out on it. We already lost the money from the first ticket.
Right, right.
Now to have to pay this, we could not afford to miss out on this. But I told y'all, when you put God first, he gonna take care of you.
Yes.
So we went out about our business. Lord knows it hit us hard. But I preached in Maryland on Sunday.
Amen. Amen.
And I got up and I did what the Lord told me.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Even after being talked about the night before.
My Lord.
I got up and I preached the word of God. And I did what God told me to do. And we had a wonderful time in the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And they went to take up the speaker's offering. And they said, if we don't get what we want the first time, we're going to call y'all on the ground the second time. So give what you can the first time so we don't got to call around the second time. So I tapped the brother next to me. And I said, brother, I said, let the other brother know that whatever in the offering, let it be that. Don't call them people up a second time. Mm-hmm. Whatever's in there, let it be what it is. Don't call them people up a second time. Because I don't preach for money.
Amen. Amen.
Woe be unto me if I preach not the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So, he got up, he told him, went on about our business. And the brother came up to us at the end and he pulled me to the side. He said, I didn't want to do this in front of the people. He said, but here's your offering. And when he gave me the offering, I already looked at it and I said, well, this looks kind of funny. But you know, then my mind started wondering, well, see, you know, people give ones a lot, you know, so it could be just a lot of ones in here.
Mm-hmm.
That's making the envelope puff up. So I just put it on in my pocket, thank God for it, and went about my business. And we didn't count it until later. So I gave it to my wife and I said, go ahead and count it. So she went to counting it. Went to counting it. Went to counting it. With the countenance.
Yeah.
With the countenance.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
She said, what? Oh, no. I said, what? She said, what did you use? I said, I only used 10. I pulled 10 out to go to the gas station or something that I just did. And I just went to my pocket and pulled it out real quick. She said, well, if I add that to that, she said, that's what $700.
My Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
You ain't got to thank God.
Thank you, Lord. That's my kind of God. That's what he does. That's just like God.
That's why I tell y'all, y'all better stop believing God. Y'all ain't got no man of God in front of you that don't believe God.
Amen.
And God keep proving himself.
Amen.
If God gonna do it to me, what you think he gonna do to you? As long as you stay underneath the covering.
Amen.
But if you move from underneath me, the blessing won't pour.
Amen.
I looked at that, I said, you gotta be kidding me. She said, it's $700. So I contacted the brother. I said, brother, I said, we just had the chance to count what was in the envelope. And I said, y'all did not have to do that. I said, I see where there was money that was added into the envelope.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all didn't have to do that. He said, brother, he said, you was worth every penny.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
He said, the word that you preach to us, we needed it.
Thank you, Lord.
He said, the ministry that you have, he said, I believe God only got a few people that are standing. And he said, I believe that you're one of them.
Amen.
And he said, I've been blessed by the ministry that is coming forth from you. He said, you deserve every penny.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Then he texts back. And he said, the extra money that was added to the envelope was from a minister at the church.
My Lord.
But check this out, y'all. He's a prophet.
Ah, ah. Thank you, Lord.
He's a prophet. And he said, prophet, Mike added the extra that was stuck in the envelope.
My Lord.
He said that he was going to give it to you in your hand. He said, but he thought it might be embarrassing maybe if he did it that way. So he did it this way.
Thank you, Lord.
In order that nothing had to be said about it.
My Lord Jesus.
But he added the extra. See, let me let y'all know something. When God worked with somebody prophetically,
that's
God
right.
will let somebody know what you
what
need.
What you need.
For the people of God, and will make them reimburse you.
Amen.
So that lets me know that God spoke something to him.
Yeah, that's right.
In order for him to move to do what he did.
Amen. Amen.
God will bless you if you take care of his business first.
Yes, that's right.
So I get that testimony to help you carry his job.
Right.
All right. The God I serve never fails.
Never.